It's closing day on a house, your home, whether you're the seller or the buyer. Are you a first-time buyer and you've never been to a closing table? Are you a seller and maybe it's been a while? Oh my gosh, what do I bring? Is it in person? Is it virtual? Is it mail away? What documents do I need to have? Oh my gosh, it's so close yet it seems so far away. Well, I'm about to tell you exactly how this goes, and it starts right now. Hi, welcome back. I'm Maria Wells, broker owner of Lifestyle Realty Group here on the Treasure Coast of Florida. Well, you have worked so hard, whether you are a buyer or seller, to get ready to close on a house. One's going to get money and one's going to get the keys. So now what do you do on closing day? What do you need to bring? How do you make this happen? So if you are a buyer and you got a loan, you're going to receive a few days before closing what's called the ALTA, A-L-T-A. It stands for the American Title Land Association Settlement Statement. That gives you at the very bottom the amount of money that you are going to need to bring to closing. Now, you're not going to physically go and walk in and bring the money, okay? But what you are going to do is wire the money and make sure you do it securely and safely. Call and speak to the title company. Don't take any wire instructions through an email. Want to make sure that nothing happens. If you are doing cash, you can't just show up with the cash. You must also wire that same word of advice. Make sure that you have spoken to the title company and gotten the correct wiring instructions so that you know that your money is safe. You need to also bring, most likely, the home insurance binder to prove that you have home insurance, especially if you're getting a loan, and ID. They're going to want ID to make sure you're the right buyer and you're the right seller. So let's talk about the ways we can do closing. All right, so closing can happen four different ways. One, it can be virtual. So what happens is that the title company uploads all of the closing documents into a portal where the buyer and seller have access. A virtual title company will go on and explain every single document. You will sign it, you will verify it's you, you will give information, your license or whatever, so that it gets completed and closed that way, and the buyer gets the keys and the seller gets their money. Now you ask, what kind of documents? Well, if you're getting a loan, there will be thousands, it seems like, no really, it's like 100 pages for your loan that the loan company basically says to you, that you're signing away your firstborn child and anything else should you default on that loan. A seller is going to sign a 1099 that's reported to the IRS in case you've made money on the house, because we don't want to think they don't get their taxes. And you're also going to sign the deed. The most important thing is the deed that says that the seller is conveying it to the buyer. You also do a bill of sale, which everything that was agreed in the contract is in writing. And a couple other agreements, if it's cash, that are very simple. You know, for instance, if there's a mistake from either party, both parties agree to come and make sure that it's right. So there's not a lot of documents if it's cash, but you have a lot of documents if it's a loan. That is how you do it virtually. Number two, it can be a mail away. So the title company will email all the documents to either the buyer or seller. You print them out and you take them to a notary, and you need one other witness, because in Florida, it needs two witnesses. The notary can be one and then one other. You get that completed per the instructions. You slip it into an overnight envelope and it arrives to the title of the company the next day. The buyer gets the keys, the seller gets their money. Number three can be an in-person closing, which means that all parties are in the same room, or it could be outside in a tent or wherever they're doing it, so that you again show your ID, you sign all of the documents, as I had just discussed, and the buyer gets the keys and the seller gets the money. The other way you can do it is an e-sign. Many times a buyer in Florida can do an e-signing. The documents are sent and it's just very simple, click of a button. We all do that many times on a contract and that's it. But the seller cannot do an e-sign because the deed, the most important document that I just mentioned, must be a wet signature. So buyer can do e-sign, seller cannot do an e-sign. But once everything is done and it's signed, questions answered, everybody's discussed the do's and don'ts of the house and what things might work. As I said to you, the buyer gets the key and the seller gets the money. And it's a great day for everyone. So I'm so happy you had happy house hunting.